Today we are going to talk about some grammatica. We're going to talk about some verbs that are called stem changers. So these are words or verbs in Spanish that are slightly irregular, and we're going to see why. Before we get into these stem changing verbs today, just want to take a few moments and review what we've already learned about our Spanish verbs in the present tense. First, remember that an infinitive is a verb that has not been conjugated. And there are three different types of infinitives. They end with either AR, like the verb hablar, ER, like the verb correr, or IR, like the verb escribir. And when the verb ends with any of those three endings, it means to do that thing. So back last quarter, we talked about the process of conjugating our verbs. And so there's two steps to this process. And remember, the first one is when we get rid of that AR, ER, or IR. What we have left is called the stem, and that's an important term for today's lesson. So the stem is what is left once we get rid of that AR, ER, or IR. So then what we're going to do is add our new ending based on the subject, the yo or the tú or the nosotros, for example. So we're going to put our new ending onto the stem. So just a quick review of these endings, which we will be using today, so hopefully you remember these. We have our AR verb endings. O, as, a, amos, ais, an. Our ER verb endings. O, ais, a, amos, ais, en. And our IR verb endings. O, ais, a, imos, is, en. And remember that our ER verb endings are almost the same as those AR verb endings, just swapping out the letter A for the letter E. And our IR verb endings are almost the same as those ER verb endings, with the exception of the nosotros and vosotros forms. We will be using these verb endings today on the stem changing verbs we're going to take a look at as well. Some regular verbs that have these AR endings, when we conjugate them, that have to do with cooking, our new topic, are cocinar, cenar, desayunar, and tomar. Cocinar, of course, means to cook. Cenar is to eat dinner. Desayunar is to eat breakfast. And tomar means to drink. It can also mean to take. But when we're talking about food and drink, it can also mean to drink. Some ER verb endings that go along with our food unit, we have comer, which is, of course, to eat, beber, to drink, and there's really not too many IR verbs that correspond to our food unit, but we'll just look at, for right now, the verb escribir, just to review. Remember that escribir means to write. So take a moment. And you're going to do a little practice here with our regular verbs. So, number one, yo blank con mi familia en el comedor. So, you're going to select the correct conjugation of that verb comer in parentheses. Number two, mi padre blank a las seis de la mañana. Number three, mis hermanos blank en el menú en el restaurante. Number four, tú blank el café. Number five, mi familia y yo blank a las seis y media. So now we're going to talk about these stem-changing verbs. As the name implies, these verbs are irregular because they have a change in their stem. And remember, the stem is what's left when we get rid of that AR, ER, or IR. These verbs are all in your Quizlet, so you may have noticed in the parentheses next to each one, you see the UE next to probar, the IE next to querer, and it says in the definition of the verb, whether it's an ER or EI stem changer, UE stem changer. So we're going to take a look at that right now. So the three types of stem changers we're going to talk about today are ones that change from O to UE, verbs that change from E to IE, and verbs that change from E to I. So let's start with those O to UE stem changers. So two verbs we're going to look at. First, we will start with almorzar, which means to eat lunch. And you can see that O that's underlined, that is what is going to change to that UE. So we're going to follow the same steps. We're going to get rid of that AR. We're going to use the same endings we've been practicing with, but we have to add that extra step of changing the O to a UE. So our yo form is almuerzo. So notice how we've changed that O to the UE. We still have that yo ending on it, the O, that hasn't changed, but we do have to change the stem. So yo almuerzo is I eat lunch. Two, almuerzas. Our usted, él, or ella form, almuerza. Now notice here our nosotros form does not change. We do not have any stem change there. We also do not have a stem change in our vosotros form. So we have almorzamos and almorzais. And then our ustedes or ellos, ellas form, we get almuerzan. So we're back to that stem changer there. Probar is another verb that is an O to UE stem changer. This means to taste or to try when you're talking about foods. So we're going to once again change that O to a UE. So we get pruebo. Once again, this is another AR verb, so we're going to have the exact same AR verb endings we've seen before. Pruebas. Prueba. But notice our nosotros form is probamos. We are not changing that form. Probáis is another one we're not going to change. And then we have our ustedes or ellos, ellas form is prueban. So when we look at these two verbs, you'll notice that all of those different stems change except for the nosotros and the vosotros forms. So if we look at our verb chart, we can draw around the different forms that do change. Our yo, tu, usted, él, ella, and ustedes, ellos, ellas forms all change in the stem. And so these verbs have a nickname. They are referred to as boot verbs because if you can kind of imagine, you have to use your imagination a little bit here, but if we look at what's in that orange shape on the chart, it kind of resembles a boot a little bit because we've left out the nosotros and vosotros forms. So for that reason, we can refer to these as boot verbs. So we've looked at our O to UE stem changers. We're going to practice a little bit now with those verbs. So take a moment and you're going to select the correct form of the verb to complete each sentence. Number one, ¿a qué hora tú blank? Number two, yo blank a las 12 de la tarde. Number three, mi madre blank la comida cuando ella cocina. Number four, mis amigos y yo blank la comida de la cafetería. Es terrible. We also have verbs that change from E to IE. We're going to start today with the verb preferir for E to IE stem changers. So this one actually has two E's in the stem. If we get rid of that IR, we're left with the stem prefer. So it's that second E that is going to be the one that changes. So this is an IR verb. We're going to use our IR verb endings we already know. So we get yo prefiero, I prefer. Tú prefieres, you prefer. Usted, él or ella, prefiere. He or she prefers, or the formal you prefer. But nosotros preferimos. Vosotros preferís. Then we have ustedes or ellos, ellas prefieren. Once again, leaving out the nosotros and vosotros forms. Another E to IE stem changer that we're already familiar with is the verb querer, to want. So that E in the stem, of course, is going to change to IE. So we get yo quiero, I want. Tú quieres, you want. Usted, él or ella quiere. Nosotros queremos, no stem change there. Vosotros queréis, no stem change there. and ustedes or ellos, ellas quieren. We can once again see that in both of these verbs, we are not changing the stem in the nosotros and vosotros forms. So take a look at the chart and you can see once again our boots. Let's practice with these stem changers. Number one, K2 blank, la pizza o la ensalada. Number two, mis hermanos y yo blank comer el helado. Number three, yo blank almorzar en mi casa. Number four, mis amigos blank hacer un pastel para mi cumpleaños. We're going to take a look at E to I stem changers as well. We'll start with the verb pedir. Pedir means to ask for or to order. So this is a good verb to use when you're talking about being in a restaurant and ordering food. So that E in our stem is going to change to I. So we get yo pido, I order or I ask for. Tú pides. Usted, él or ella pide. But nosotros pedimos. Vosotros pedís. And ustedes, ellos or ellas piden. Servir means to serve. So this is another verb we can use when we're talking about being in a restaurant, the waiter serving food. It is an E to I stem changer, so we get yo sirvo, tú sirves. Usted, él or ella, sirve. Nosotros servimos, vosotros servís, and ustedes, ellos or ellas sirven. Once again, we see that we are not changing the stem for nosotros and vosotros forms. And there are the boots. Let's practice with these verbs. Mi madre nunca blank el postre cuando vamos a un restaurante. Number two. K2 blank en tu restaurante favorito. Number three. Mi abuela blank el pollo para la cena. We're going to take a look at one bonus stem changer. So we're actually going to look at a fourth type of stem changer, a verb that we use quite a bit. And this is a U to UE stem changer. So we're really just adding that E in there. And the verb is jugar, to play a game or a sport. So this is a verb that we use a lot. And you'll want to know this before you go on to Spanish 2, that this is a stem changer. So that U in the stem is going to change to UE. So that's where we get yo juego. Tú juegas. Usted, él or ella juega. But nosotros jugamos. Vosotros jugáis. And then ustedes, ellos or ellas juegan. So everything changes except for those two forms, nosotros and vosotros, leaving us with the stem changers in the boot. Let's practice with all of these different types of verbs we've seen today. Number one, mis amigos y yo blank los videojuegos durante la cuarentena. Cuarentena, you may be able to figure out, is quarantine. Number two, K2 blank comer para la cena. Number three, mis hermanos y yo blank ir a un restaurante para el desayuno. Number four. Cuando hace buen tiempo, yo blank en el patio de mi casa. Number five. En el restaurante, mi hermano blank el pollo frito con papas fritas. Number six. Mi hermana y yo blank el helado nuevo de Grater's. Number seven. Mi madre blank leche chocolate con el desayuno. Muy bien! You are all done for today. Buen trabajo! Great job studying and learning your stem-changing verbs.